Thanks for watching the Council in Brief. I'm Susan Kennedy. We're here with the latest news of the Montgomery County Council. Safety for seniors was the topic of the most recent session of the Council's Public Safety Committee, where members discuss a number of senior safety initiatives aimed at protecting that population. Recently, the number of cases where seniors have been victims of fraud and identity theft have been on the rise, and there are other daily security issues that face the elderly. Council members say these issues often require a multi-agency approach.
The briefing was broken down into four areas: fraud and identity theft, physical crimes against seniors, heat-related emergencies, and Montgomery County Fire and Rescue Service's Senior Safety Initiative. Committee members say there needs to be a multi-agency approach to dealing with these issues.
Over the years, obviously, things become more obvious and more evident, and that we need to make certain that we're doing everything that we possibly can. For fire and rescue, the idea that when they go to visit someone in their home, that they will go with someone from Meals on Wheels, which I did not realize that they did that until yesterday, and that's a great idea.
I wasn't aware that they go out to the homes of seniors and do a full free assessment of someone's home. They look at their burners, they look at their stove, they look at the gas lines, they replace your smoke detector with a contemporary smoke detector with a 10-year battery, and they do a full house or apartment assessment. So I'm actually invited them to a civic association I'm speaking to tonight. I'm going to continue to do that, because when I'm out speaking to different neighborhood associations, most of the people in the audience are either seniors or the caregivers for other seniors.
Officials told committee members that although seniors are victims of fraud and identity theft, they are no more vulnerable to it than other groups. Committee members say they want the county to do a better job of getting the word out about some of the services available to seniors, many of which come at no cost.
So the county provides for free inspections of buildings, including apartment buildings, based on safety concerns. So it could be lighting, it could be vegetative growth in the wrong places, it could be any number of things that would make a building less safe. And they offer this for free. And if a resident requests that the county come out and look at this, the county can't do it unless the property owner agrees to it, the owner of the apartment building. And we want to change that, because there have been apartment building owners that have not been willing to allow this.
In other news, council members say they are concerned that Barwood Taxi may be charging its drivers too much when a passenger pays with a credit card. Council members tell us they have been provided with information that Barwood has been circumventing a provision of a bill the council passed in July that provides more taxi cab licenses for individual drivers.
If you're a county resident and you pay a bill by credit card, we add on 2.5% to cover the credit card processing fee. We had told the owners of the cab companies they could add 1% to cover what we thought was the credit card processing fee. So what we discover is that now this fee is more than credit card processing, and it appears to be related to equipment and other things that have nothing to do with credit card processing.
In response to concerns from constituents regarding tree removal at the Swains Lock Campground, Councilmember Roger Berliner plans to hold a community conversation. The meeting will be held November 7th at the site in the CNO National Historic Park. Park officials say they need to remove 26 trees and prune 32 others that could be hazardous to park users. Councilmember Berliner told us a certified arborist who examined the trees will be on hand at the meeting to answer questions.
Big, tall, mature trees are near and dear to our community. And so some citizens happened to see it and contacted me, and then I immediately picked up the phone and called our very great superintendent, Kevin Brandt, and said, "Kevin, what is going on here?" And he said, "Okay, we're going to put a halt to this immediately." And I said I'd be happy to work with him to create a public conversation about this, so at least people have an understanding of why they felt they needed to take down these trees.
Again, that meeting is November 7th, and the conversation will begin at 9 a.m. Well, that does it for this edition of the Council in Brief. For County Cable Montgomery, I'm Susan Kennedy. Thanks for watching.